Give your app a voice. I mean a real human-like voice your customers can have a full conversation with, not just type app. An assistant trained on your entire business, creating conversations so fluid and natural, your users will swear they're talking to a real person. And we're going to build it right now in just three simple steps. Let's build. Let's build. Let's build.
ElevenLabs have just released version 2 of their conversational AI agent, building upon the impressive foundation laid by version 1, which debuted just 5 months ago. Version 2 brings us closer to voices nearly indistinguishable from human speech, with latency so low that interactions feel as natural as conversing with a real person. Maintaining such low latency is no small feat, especially considering the significant enhancements introduced in this version, things like integrated retrieval augmented generation, or RAG, automatic language detection, a new state-of-the-art turn-taking model, multimodal interaction, and enterprise-grade security and compliance features.
And thanks to a new FlutterFlow Marketplace library,
adding your own personalized voice agent to your apps has never been easier, giving your users instant access to real-time conversational support and features.
First up, let's get acquainted with the ElevenLabs dashboard. You'll find it at elevenlabs.io/app. Then click on Conversational AI. And in the Playground section, you'll find four very different agents you can converse with in real time to inspire you.
Hey there, I'm Alexis from ElevenLabs Support. How can I help you today?
Hey there. Thanks for taking this moment for yourself. Let's begin by introducing ourselves. I'm Joe. What's your name?
Hi there. I'm Harper from ElevenLabs. How could ElevenLabs Conversational AI help your business today?
Greetings, traveler. How can I assist you on your quest?
These are fantastic starting points to spark your imagination, and they showcase how you can use conversational AI in various roles.
Let's select the support agent and click Create Agent.
This will take us to the main agent setup screen. Here you can choose the primary language for your agent and add any other languages you want it to understand. Next, you'll see a field for the first message. In our FlutterFlow app, the user will need to press a button to start the conversation. So it's a good idea to set this message to something like, press the microphone button to start a chat. Now for the system prompt. This is where we'll shape our agent's personality. ElevenLabs has a brilliant AI feature to help with this. I'm going to create a sales agent for FlutterFlow that specializes in implementing custom code. And knows all about the ways this can be done. As you can see, the AI generates a detailed and well-structured prompt tailored for the conversational AI agent. It's a great starting point that you can easily build upon. The default large language model is set to Gemini, but you can use any LLM you prefer, including custom ones. I've even used Grok in the past. You can also adjust the temperature to make your agent more creative or more deterministic. And I like to keep the token usage in check to prevent the agent from being too wordy. So I'll lower it from the default unlimited setting to around about 400. In the next section, you can give your agent a knowledge base by uploading documents one by one, or setting up retrieval augmented generation. Then in the tools section, you'll see tools like End Call and Detect Language, which you can toggle on or off. You can also enable things like call transfers to a human agent or to a phone number. And you can set up your own custom tools for your agent to use. These are tools in much the same way that an LLM has tools. So you can think of them that way. You can even give your agent access to custom MCP servers, as well as securely store and share credentials and auth connections across your workspace. Don't forget to hit that save button. Now let's move on to the voice tab. Here you can choose from ElevenLabs' vast library of voices.
I think this is a really nice way to just talk naturally together, you know, talk plain.
Hey, what's up, guys? This is Finn.
I just love talking about movies.
What's up, everybody? It's your boy Jamal here.
I think this is a really nice way to just talk naturally together, you know, talk plainly. Let's give it a shot.
You can even set up different voices for different languages. There's also a toggle for Flash, which offers lower latency, but without some of the advanced pronunciation features of the turbo and multilingual models. You can configure webhooks to pull in data at the start of a call or send data to your backend after the call ends. You'll also find more advanced settings and important privacy features. The final tab is for the test widget, but I find it often better to just jump in and have a test call with your agent to see how it performs before integrating it into your FlutterFlow project.
Hey there, I'm Mark from FlutterFlow Support. I'm here to help you with all things custom code.
Can you help me get the PDF package from pub.dev into FlutterFlow?
Absolutely. You can integrate packages like the PDF package from pub.dev into FlutterFlow by adding custom code. FlutterFlow allows you to include external packages through custom actions or custom widgets, which makes it flexible for advanced features like PDF generation. Would you like guidance on how to set up the package in your project, or how to create a custom widget for PDF handling?
Well, what's the difference between a custom widget and a custom action, anyway?
Great question! A custom widget in FlutterFlow is a reusable UI component that you create with custom code, allowing you to design unique visual elements or complex layouts.
At the top of the page, you'll find your agent ID. Make sure to copy that because we'll need it in a moment. Now let's get things set up on the FlutterFlow side. First stop, FlutterFlow Marketplace, and search for ElevenLabs. Click on ElevenLabs Conversational AI and add it to your project. This will make it available in your project's dependency screen as a library. Once you add it to your project, you'll see it's asking for two things. These are your agent ID, which you already have from the ElevenLabs dashboard, and your endpoint, which we're going to need a backend for. Now, we use a backend in conjunction with FlutterFlow's frontend when we need to engage an external service or API, and we don't want to expose our API key. Private API keys have no place on the front end. I'm using a backend called BuildShip here because you can find a template called Get Signed ElevenLabs URL in their templates section, which is exactly what we need here. But I'll also include links to Xano and N8N backend templates, which you can use for this. All you need to do is add in your ElevenLabs API key to the key section in your backend. So in BuildShip, you'll find that by clicking the key icon here. we'll head back to the ElevenLabs dashboard and to our profile section. You'll find API keys. It's always a good idea to restrict your API keys where possible. Now for this integration, your agent only needs read access to these services. Now, copy your new key into the key section in your backend and deploy your endpoint, which will provide a signed ElevenLabs URL back to FlutterFlow to safeguard our API key. With that setup done, let's build the interface for our agent. This library comes with some pre-built components to make this super easy. First, let's drag the recording button component onto our page. This is the magic button that starts the microphone and kicks off the real-time conversation with our agent. You can customize it completely. You can change the size, the icon, the colors for when it's recording and when it's not, and even toggle a little pulse animation. Next, we can choose to show the transcription back from ElevenLabs to our user. The transcription bubbles component is perfect for this and works best inside a list view. It's an optional component, but it's a fantastic way to quickly display the back and forth chat that your user is having with the agent. But before any of this can occur, we need to set up an on-page load action, which initializes the conversational service and sets up our WebSocket connection. Select your page, go to the Actions tab and click On-Page Load Action. The action we need is a custom action from our library called Initialize Conversational Service. This action sets up the connection to ElevenLabs as soon as the page opens. Now let's set up our chat bubbles. Select your list view and have it generate its children from the conversation messages app state variable, which the library conveniently created for us. We'll then pass the data from each list item into our transcription bubbles component. You can give your agent a custom name and logo right here in the component's parameters as well. If you want more control, you can always access the raw transcription data yourself using the JSON response to build a completely custom UI.
Every turn or response sent or received from ElevenLabs is stored as a custom data type that the library imported called ElevenLabs response. And these are saved in a list in the app state variable conversation messages. So you can access the chat history via this variable. You can distinguish between an agent message or a user message with the type field.
Now, don't forget permissions. Before we initialize, we need to ask for permissions. You'll need to request both microphone and Bluetooth permissions. The microphone is for talking to the agent, obviously, and Bluetooth is for anyone using a Bluetooth headset to talk to their agent.
In order for your agent to work correctly on Android, you'll also need to add these two custom permissions at the bottom of the permissions settings screen, like so. I'll include these in the description so you can copy and paste. Make sure you add the request permission actions before the initialize conversational service action on page load. Oh, and one last thing. There's an optional on-init callback. We can use this to trigger an action every time a new component initializes in the list. For example, let's let it scroll our list view to the very bottom so the user always sees the latest transcription message.
Hey there, I'm Mark from FlutterFlow Support. I'm here to help you with all things custom code. Click the microphone button to start a chat.
Hi, Mark. I'm new to FlutterFlow and want to know what the difference between a custom widget and a custom action is.
Hi, great question. A custom widget in FlutterFlow is a reusable UI component that you create with your own layout and design, allowing you to build unique visual elements. A custom action, on the other hand, is a piece of custom code that performs a specific function or operation like fetching data or updating the app state. Would you like me to explain how to create either one or give you examples of each?
No, so what's the difference then with a custom class? And there you have it. In just three steps, we've integrated a powerful human-like AI voice agent into our FlutterFlow app. With ElevenLabs Conversational AI, your users can enjoy personalized, real-time interactions that feel genuinely human. If you found this tutorial helpful, don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the bell icon for more videos. Happy building, and I'll see you soon.